In this podcast, we will give you an insight into the new features of EDIUS 10.10. Motion tracking with scaling and rotation. Render and add to timeline. Thumbnails for markers. Easy cancellation of multiple jobs. Skin tone line in Vectorscope. In EDIUS 10, you have various options for using motion tracking. You can track using the mask filter and apply a filter within the mask on the tracked object. Or you can attach something to the tracked object or anchor an object by using the layouter or transform filter. In the EDIUS 10 preview video, we showed you how to easily attach a label, animation, or video clip to a tracked object. With the version 10.10 update, EDIUS 10 can now use the scaling and rotation tracking information and transfer it to the attached or anchored object. Once you have finished the tracking, just right-click into the preview of tracking and choose Apply Tracking, Scale, and/or Rotation. With these additional motion tracker options, you have many new possibilities available in EDIUS 10. Render and add to timeline. You might have noticed that the render option, render and add to timeline, was missing in the initial release of EDIUS 10. This option is now available again with version 10.10. Especially when you work in a complex project with multiple layers, this function helps you to save time rendering when making changes on the timeline. You can go to the EDIUS menu bar, click on render, and then choose Render and Add to Timeline. Or you use the Render option from the context menu by pressing the Render button above the timeline. Or you simply use the shortcut Shift and Q. Thumbnails for markers. Sequence and clip markers can be very helpful, especially in bigger projects. They allow you to mark and annotate a specific point or area, mark long passages, represent chapter marks, help synchronizing, and much more. EDIUS 10 version 10.10 now shows thumbnails in the marker list. This helps you locate markers visually and speeds up your workflow. Easy cancellation of multiple jobs. The new render service of EDIUS 10 operates in the background. You can watch the render service through the GV job monitor in the Tools menu. While jobs are rendered in the background, you are able to continue editing. Sometimes, you may prefer to stop background jobs. Version 10.10 now lets you easily cancel multiple jobs in the GV job monitor. Skin tone line in Vectorscope. Sometimes you come across video material that has a color shift. EDIUS offers a lot of different color grading filters to correct the picture. To measure the correct color, the Vectorscope is the right tool. Version 10.10 now adds a skin tone line in Vectorscope, which allows you to adjust the color correctly. The skin tone line is the line between yellow and red in the Vectorscope. It represents the color of blood running under our skin. So the skin tone line is always the same, regardless of the actual skin color. To check the skin tone for a clip, you can use the mask filter to select only a part of the person's skin. In the Vectorscope, you will now see the saturation and hue values of the skin tone. Apply a color correction filter and adjust it until the skin tone of the person in your shot is directly on the line. Once you are happy with the results, deactivate the mask filter. Click here for the next podcast. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. Visit EDIUS.NET for more information about EDIUS, plugins, tutorials, and the latest downloads.